Pinterest is a visual search engine, and this itself tells you that Pinterest should be a great place to promote a photography business. People love sharing beautiful images, landscapes, unique, unusual photos, and so on. So it's true that great photos can get a ton of repins on Pinterest. But how do you use Pinterest to actually get clients to your photography business? This question doesn't have a short answer, and that's why I decided to talk about it in my video today. Hi, I'm Anastasia of AnastasiaBlogger.com. I'm a Pinterest marketing expert, and on this channel, I share my Pinterest and online business tips on Thursdays. If that's what you want to learn about, you know all the buttons you need to click, right? Subscribe and hit the bell button to get notified about my new tutorials. This video today will be helpful not only if you're a photographer looking for clients, but also for several other types of businesses inside the photography niche. For example, if you share photography tips or sell photography educational content, I will show you some really good examples of how people promote them on Pinterest. Also, if you're offering Pinterest management services to clients who run a photography business, this video will also help you learn the best practices that work for this particular niche. So let's get started. First and foremost, to promote your business on Pinterest, you need to have a business account and verify your site on Pinterest. I don't like repeating myself in the videos, so I'll just direct you to my previous tutorials. And if you're a complete beginner and you need to create a business account on Pinterest from scratch, I have another video and you will find a link to it in the top right corner and in the description below this video. The second step would be analyzing your niche and building your boards on Pinterest. Again, in the description below this video, I will give you all the links to my tutorials that will show you how to set up your account, how to create boards, and everything you need to know as a new account owner on Pinterest, step by step, step one, step two, and so on. So I'd like to first start with showing you how you can investigate how popular is your particular type of business inside photography niche. When you go to pinterest.com/categories, you see this page that is shown to all the new users once they first sign up on this platform. And you will see here that one of the big categories on Pinterest is photography. If we open it, we'll see that this category has 91.8 million followers right now. And while you're scrolling down this page, you will see here how popular are some of the pins that are in this niche, like 44,000 repins, almost 100,000 repins for this pin, etc. But when you reach the bottom part of the page, you will see several subcategories or subtopics inside the photography big niche, and you will see that the popular ones that we can find here: wedding photography, street photography, nature photography, animal photography, then photojournalism. But let me just show you some of them that I already opened. For example, for wedding photography, you will find out that it has almost 18 million followers on Pinterest. And I encourage you to investigate further what kind of pins are getting so much traction on Pinterest and why, and whether or not they are related to your niche. For example, I found this particular pin quite interesting. It has about 14,000 repins on Pinterest. So I opened the pin itself. I see that it's linked to a site of a wedding photographer. I already know that she's a wedding photographer. And because I already went to her site and I wanted to show you her Pinterest account, you will see that it's almost 1 million monthly viewers. If you look at her boards, you will find out that she's specifying in the description where she's located, in Arizona, right? So she's looking for clients in this state. And then she shows some examples of her work. And then you will see that she's not only saving pins that are focused on wedding photography, she has some other boards that are not directly related to wedding photography. She has some family photo ideas board and other types of photography. So that's why I'm trying to always say that on Pinterest, it's important to have a little bit broader appeal when you're building your boards. You shouldn't be super focused on or super niched down if you want to get good traction on Pinterest. When you're going to discover more of these topics related to the initial photography category, you will see that in the related topics, you'll find some very good ideas for the titles of your boards. For example, here we're looking at wedding photography poses. It has about 42,000 followers on Pinterest. And here you will find more ideas for your board titles, for example, groom poses. If you're focused on wedding photography, definitely some of these keywords are going to be in your board titles. Now, the other topic, for example, street photography has 1 million followers, animal photography, 136,000 followers, kids photography, about 10,000 followers, and so on. Another place where you can also look for information about how big is your audience on Pinterest is Pinterest Analytics Audience Insights, and then you will go to Audience Insights for all Pinterest users. You'll need to click on this button. And then inside the categories, you will see there's a category art. Unfortunately, I cannot find the photography category separately, but if I look inside art category, I'll see here that there is photography. It's quite a popular subcategory inside art, and art is one of the top as well, one of the top categories. I'd like to go really quickly over the basics for you to understand what you need to do step by step on your account. So first, once you created your account, you need to probably use some profile picture that either is your own photo or maybe it represents somehow what kind of photography you offer to your clients, and then explain in the title of your profile if it's important for you that you want to only get clients in your specific location. I would recommend to have your location right here in the name of your account, Pinterest profile, and then you have a field for description. It's a little bit longer, so here you can add some information about the type of photography that you're selling, and you can also mention again the location if it is important for you. In this case, I like that this photographer mentions what type of photos or what style of photos she's offering to her clients. My next tip would be, maybe specifically for this profile, how she could improve her presence on Pinterest is by using vertical photos or vertical images. Maybe she could even repurpose the same photos that she already has on her profile, that they're horizontal, but she could add something on top. Like maybe she could make like a small collage of two photos, and then on top of it she could even add a text overlay to generate more clicks and to have taller images, because that's how this platform works. On Pinterest, you have to know that images have to be vertical. 80% of the audience are on mobile devices. That's how the platform works in the vertical format. So if you have a lot of horizontal images, you're just losing a lot of exposure on Pinterest and losing some traffic to your competitors who spend the extra time and effort for creating those vertical images. The recommended image ratio on Pinterest is 2:3, and the maximum height of your image can be 1:2. When it gets taller than 1:2 image ratio, Pinterest is gonna cut off the bottom part of the pin, and your pins will not get as much distribution because they're too tall. Another thing that is missing on this account's pins is either her domain name or some logo of some kind, because there's no any kind of watermark on her photos. And this is bad because Pinterest platform has this particular problem of stolen pins. So it's very easy for people who want to redirect traffic from your images to their sites. It's very easy for them to steal your content, and it's harder for you to prove that it really is your content when you don't have any kind of watermark, or at least your domain name somewhere at the bottom of the pin at least. So I mentioned that you could create those taller pins just making simple collage image with a few of your photos and a text overlay on top. And if you want to know what is the easiest way of creating this kind of pin images, the easiest way, and it's a free tool, is Canva. I know that most of the photographers are pretty comfortable with Photoshop, but actually, even for professional graphic designers, I think that for this kind of collages, because Canva has the special grids, it is actually easier to create this kind of pins in Canva. It's a free online tool available to everyone. And I have a video tutorial about creating pins in Canva. I'll give you the link to this video in the top right corner and in the description below this video. And I'd like also to give you a tip about how you can manage your Pinterest account without spending too much time on the platform. Because as a business owner, as a photographer, you want to spend most of your time working with your clients, and Pinterest is probably just one of the platforms that you're using to drive traffic to your website. So I would say that if you're doing everything manually on Pinterest, you are either doing not enough pinning, because Pinterest recommends between 15 and 25 pins a day. It's like the average that the most successful accounts are saving on the platform right now. So if you don't have the time to save manually so many pins on Pinterest, then you probably might want to look at the authorized Pinterest scheduler called Tailwind. It will allow you to save each of your pins to several boards relevant to the content, to the keywords on this pin on your pin title and description of your pin. The scheduler will help you save each of your pins to several relevant boards. That's actually helping you get exposure to bigger audience on Pinterest, because each of your boards might have slightly different keyword, also related to the keywords that you have in the title of your pin and in the description of your pin, but slightly different keywords. So you're going to show your pin to a bigger audience rather than if you saved it just once to one board on your Pinterest account. Now again, I have a detailed tutorial that explains how to use Tailwind Scheduler. If you feel that you're spending way too much time on Pinterest and you still want to maintain the same level of activity on the platform, then check out that video. I'll give you a link in the top right corner and in the description below this video. Now I'm going to show you a couple of examples of accounts that are doing particularly great on Pinterest, and they will be from different types of photography business. For example, this company, they are creative photography, showing behind the scenes. They have a strong presence on Instagram and on YouTube, and also on Pinterest. Now that we're looking at their account, it's a 6.7 million monthly viewers. And what I find really interesting about this account, they have just a few boards and they mostly have video pins that I think that they are creating these video pins from the content they already have on other platforms. So if it's your case, you could also repurpose content like they're doing. If I open some of these videos just to show you what they're doing here, they're basically showing some tips about photography, and they have a lot of engagements. Unfortunately, we cannot see the number of repins here, but I can assure you that all of these videos are getting viral effect because they have super high engagement scores. As you can see from this example, Pinterest doesn't have to be a really hard hustle, because they just uploaded here the content that they already have on other platforms, and it works great for them. Their account is doing really well and they're sending traffic to their YouTube videos. You see they're linking to YouTube videos here or to their site directly. And also we can see that on their site, they're selling some Lightroom presets, and from these pins, they're sending traffic from Pinterest directly to their presets. Another interesting example here is this account that is promoting some Photoshop tips, photography tips, and basically it's an educational site for beginner photographers. And we can see here that she's not selling actually her own services, but she's mostly selling educational content around photography niche. And she has a membership site for beginner photographers. If we look at her account in particular, we'll see here that she has 1.3 million monthly viewers on Pinterest. She has a lot more boards in this case, and her strategy is kind of different. If we look at her account, we'll find out here that most of her pins are linked to some educational content. In this case, it's in particular to her podcast episodes. And then she's always adding some text overlay on top of the pin. If you look at her pins, you will realize that she must use this text overlays with how-to and other attractive call to action phrases that will help her get actual traffic from these pins. Otherwise, it would be just a pretty picture of a girl, and maybe some people would save it as an idea for whatever their kid photography session, but they wouldn't have a reason to click through. Now with this text overlay, she explains why the users need to click through and what they will learn from this article.
Again, when I was looking for some popular pins, I found this one with lots of engagements and a ton of comments. That's what actually, just for your information, if you don't know how to understand which pins are popular or viral on Pinterest, if you see a ton of engagements, comments, and here, in this case, we don't have photos, but either photos or comments, if there are many of them, it indicates usually that the pin is going viral. In this case, this professional photographer showing her behind the scenes, it's just a simple video that she basically fast forwarded whatever she was doing to create the scene. And if you look at her site and go from this pin to the post, you will realize that she also sells some photography tips. You can see here that she's trying to monetize her site in different ways. She's selling her photography ebook challenge. Then she also has one-on-one consultations for beginner photographers. And then I also found this particularly popular pin with 36 comments. And when I clicked through, I realized that this type of photography business is very different from what I was showing to you so far. It's a business based on photo retouching services, and they are also sending a lot of traffic to their site from Pinterest. This is how their Pinterest account looks. They have 9 million monthly viewers. You can see their boards. It's about 6 boards, but they have a lot of pins on each of these boards. You can see that it's over 4,000, and you will realize that here they're focusing very well on the main keyword related to their services, retouch photos or digital retouching. I think that in their case, it's easy to create this engaging photos because they can show before and after, and that's what they're doing in most of their photos. They basically show examples of their work and then it goes to their page.
If you have some interesting tips that I missed in this video and you think they could help others, then share them in the comment section below this video. Now, I'm going to sign off for today. Stay safe, stay healthy, and before you leave, here are my other videos perfectly complementary to what I was sharing with you today. Check them out here and there, and I'll see you in the next videos.